Hi guys, Robbie46 here, welcome yourselves back to Ride 2. It's time to continue with some World Tour events, but first we got an Invitational to do, so let's scroll to whichever one we got to do, because I can't actually remember what we're on. Number 13. We haven't got that many left to go, so let's do event number 13. I've already seen the bike, which I'm going to choose once we've finished this one. We got the MV Agusta F4 Racing version or the JG Speedfit Kawasaki. Right, so Northwest 200 on the Smiths Racing Triumph 675R. Let's go do this. Oh shit, I've just realised I haven't changed the oil. Oil light is on, so we're going to be lacking a little bit of power than usual. Hopefully that won't matter. Hopefully we can get the win. I'm going to try anyway. But we're in 5th at the moment. I'll get used to this bike again, so used to my GSXR 600. Oh, fuck. Okay, that was a bit of an optimistic move there, Mr. AI. But I think he came off a lot worse, because I think he ended up crashing. Serves him right. Right. Into the roundabout. Catch up to the leaders, but they're not that far ahead, so we can start using the slipstream, and hopefully we can get near the top by the end of this straight, because the AI, I mean, they're not that great anyway, but along this straight they seem to be lacking a little bit of speed. We've got the slipstream, we've got one guy, we're up to fourth through the quick right-hander, and now we can get this guy, because we've got a lot more speed, up to third. Over the jump where the AI slow down a bit more. And up to second. And then into the lead. So we're in the lead already. We're going well. Get on the anchors ready for the left-hander, which can be quite tricky if you outbrake yourself, but we're in. And we're three without any dramas. Try and pull away. Let's see what kind of gap we can get by the end of this race. Well, if the AI are going to challenge me, I can't imagine they will. But you never know, I may make a mistake. Oh fuck. Look where you're going, Robbo. Got a pretty big gap already, but we've got a chicane coming up, so we need to be wary of that and get on the anchors. Oh shit, grass. Okay, so we're through the chicane without any dramas. It looked like the AI had a few dramas there. It looks like they've kind of closed in a little bit. I think they can brake a little bit later into the chicane and still make it, otherwise they just end up throwing their bikes all over the place. Need to stop looking behind me because I'm missing my turning points. Chicane. Here we go. Oh my god, one of them's crashed, but they've closed in big time in that chicane. Don't know how the fuck they got it stopped. Just have to keep pushing. That's the only two areas of this track where they're going to close in. They may close in on this. Oh fuck, yeah, they're really closing in on this corner. Oh. It sounded like one of them crashed, but I don't think they did. The AI are almost right on me again. So I need to start pushing. Over the jump. This corner and the final corner I hate. It's really weird. Got to be careful not to go over the curbs. Open up a little bit of a gap again, which is all good. Right, second to last corner, and then the horrible final corner. But it's not actually as bad as the other left-hander. It's not as tight. Still pretty bad, though. Okay, so we've got only a 1.4 second lead at the moment. Hopefully we'll extend that, especially down that long straight. Into the hairpin. Probably a little bit early on the brakes there. See what the gap is at the next split, but it looks like it's gone up a bit. At least, haven't they? Almost 2 seconds, I reckon. Closing a bit on the brakes through there. Where's the next split? Yeah, it's definitely over 2 seconds now, surely. Alright, can't even see him on the map anymore. Got a split coming up very soon. Somewhere anyway. Oh fuck, get off the grass. Where's the split? Come on. Well, let's forget about the split for the moment because we've got to put the brakes on in a minute. Right. Okay. So the next split will definitely be coming up around the left-hander. Here it comes. So, see what our gap is. It's definitely... Well, we'll find out what it is. It's over 5 seconds. So we've got over a 5 second gap. We'll see how much that comes down through both chicanes because they close up quite a bit on the first lap. I'm not saying they're going to close right in again, but it's going to be interesting to see how much time they actually take out of me through the chicanes. First one coming up. So it's pretty much bang on 5 seconds the gap. Just over. Still can't see them on the map. See if they appear on the map in the second chicane. And check out the split. When we get to it. Ooh, almost on the curb there. Through the chicane. Oh fuck! Just high-sided myself, that wouldn't have helped. They're still not on the map though. The end of this straight. Next split coming up. Right, it was 5 seconds. It's increased to 5.5. So they didn't really close in at all through the chicanes, but then I'm not sure how much we pulled out down the fast bits, down the straights. But after this last little section, we've only got one more lap to go. Just a couple more corners on this lap. Wide! Oh, so close to the curb. Right, one more lap to go. Let's not fuck up now. Is it going to tell us the gap? Yes, it is. It's over 6 seconds. 6.3 seconds. So, barring any mistakes, they're definitely not going to catch me. Right, let's do this final lap as nice as possible and we can go on and do do a new category in the World Tour events. Right, long straight coming up. We're just revving out pretty much the whole way. So let's get into sixth gear in a minute. Got that right hand there, which you can kind of go flat out on the Super Sport. On the Super Bike, definitely have to lift off. Now we're revving out. A long wait before we have to put the brakes on. It does kind of get distracting having this really, really long straight, because you just get so used to it, and then you put the brakes on and realise, fuck, I was going a lot quicker than I was expecting. A bit like when you've been on the motorway for quite a long time in real life, and then you come off of it and you're like, oh, this feels so slow. Or you don't kind of realise, because you just get used to going fast. When you slow down, it just sort of feels very slow. Okay. So the split is over 10 sec. Jesus Christ, fucking hell. Okay, I wasn't expecting it to be that big, but it's over 10 seconds now. So we've really, really pulled out. It was 6.3 over the start-finish line. So we've pulled out quite a few seconds. 4 seconds, just under. Oh, fuck. Okay. Wow. We almost fucked that one up. Could have crashed, but luckily managed to stay on. Just took the chicane a bit too tight across the curb and made us jump. Alright. Chicane coming up. I thought I was going in there a bit too hot then. Got through there nice and dandy. It's all good. Okay, so as we come to the end of this straight, we've only got the final part of the lap to go now. See what the sector time is going to be when they come through. So it was over 10 seconds. They've closed in, but I did make that mistake through the first chicane and almost ended up crashing. So that's probably where I lost some time. Through there with no dramas. Just a couple more corners to go, and we are done for this invitational event, number 13. 16 altogether, so not many left at all. There's 3 left after this one. Through the final corner. Jobs are good, and we've done invitational event number 13. Done and dusted. There we go. Nicely done. And we won by 4 seconds according to that. Okay. Right, let's pick our JG Speedfit Kawasaki. And then we can get on with the next category. Alright, we're going to do Ducati Open Days now, because we have bought ourselves a new bike. Milano is going to be the first track, because we've bought ourselves the 2017 Ducati Superleggera 1299. So let's go race with this bad boy, see what it's like. I've fully upgraded it. Let's get this one done, see what we can do. Here we go. Oh, it gets off the line really well. Fucking hell. All right, well, almost into the lead. Down the third. God, definitely, God. This accelerates like a beast. Brakes pretty well. It feels pretty quick as well. Sounds nice under the tunnel. Ducati bellow echoing under the tunnel. Alright, gotta try and find a way past this guy. An American with a very English surname. Through the right hand, nope. Outbreak him there. He's gone a little bit wide. Nothing we can capitalise on. The front does definitely keep wanting to come up, but we're just going to have to fight that all the time. Other than that, this bike feels awesome to use. Like I said, it accelerates really well at corners. Goes pretty quick and it stops well as well. Handles pretty nicely as you'd expect from a Ducati. A Ducati superbike, anyway. And no, not quite having him yet. Right, where are we going to get this guy? He's not on a Super Leggera, but I think he is on a 1299. Panigale S. The inside here! Going a bit wide, is he going to cut? No, he's not. We've closed the door on him. Alright. So into the lead. Can we? Ooh. Can we pull away? Keep that front end down. Power out of corners. Wide there myself, but we can cut that back. Very nicely done. Front coming up. Stop it. Right. Getting towards the end of lap number two. We've still got the guy right behind us. He's not that far behind. We haven't pulled away a huge amount. Hopefully in this final lap. Oh, God. Okay, so almost took me out again. Right, we really need to pull our finger out now. So let's see if we can do it. A quick third lap, third and final lap, and get away from the clutches of second place. Right, come on. Let's see what we got. Oh, we're pulling away already. It's giving us a little bit of breathing space. Can we continue it for the rest of the lap? Feeling good. First few corners have gone well. Almost a second gap, 0.8 of a second at the moment. Through the tunnel we go. Alright. We're definitely getting away from second place. Will he catch up in the final part of this lap? I'm hoping not. Seems to be pretty quick. Well, pretty late on the brakes into this next corner, the double left, but he's quite far back now. I think we got this one wrapped up nicely. Just a couple of corners left to go, the right kink, then the left-hander, and just a straight to the finish. This lap has gone a lot better than the others. And we are going to take our first victory on the Ducati Superleggera 1299. And there we go! A win on the Ducati. Really, really good bike. I want to know what that guy was on. I'm pretty sure it was a Panigale S. Right. Next race. Let's go do this. Hellenic Towers. Off we go. Superleggera getting off the line very nicely indeed as we go up the inside. Yes, we do. Ooh, the barrier a little bit, but it's fine. So we're ahead of second place. The guy that was fighting us in the first race, Mr. Smith. The American, the very British name. That wasn't a good set of corners. Too deep. Wow. Those few corners didn't go too well, but we've still got 0.7 of a second penalty. So we go right and then left and then on the brakes. Oh, too wide, too wide. He's going to come back underneath. I don't think he was close enough. So many hairpins on this track. Just hairpin after hairpin. So save for a second the gap. Which is nice. Fire it out. Trying to, of course, keep that pesky front end from coming up. A bit squirrely on the brakes. It's not that far behind. It's under a second, I reckon. Yeah, 0.6. He's closed in 0.4. As I try and remember where the track is going. Final corner. Ooh. Okay, I'll stop wheeling. 0.4. He's closed right in. You can see the arrow. He's right behind us. Should be able to pull away a little bit out of the hairpins. Drifting wide. Come back in. Still a bit too hot into there. Oh god, that was a really bad exit onto this really fast bit. But it's over a second again, despite that fuck up. That was way too late on the brakes again, that was even worse than last time. But still, he hasn't come underneath us. So we're managing to keep in the lead. We need to nail that corner next time round. 1.3 seconds, so the gap is slowly but surely extending. However, it's the last part of the lap that he seems to close in. Wide, but that's fine, we can pull it back in. Final corner again, 1.2, so he's only closing a tenth that time, it's not the final corner. Go left and then the final corner. Pretty sure he's closing a bit more though. So closing a tenth, but I think is a bit closer now, considering I got my corners mixed up. That's better at the final corner. But it is under a second again, 0.7. So now we're going to have to push in the beginning part of this lap, just because we know that's where we made up time last time. So we've all gone very wide there. It's a bit better through there. See if we can get this corner nailed. That was better, much better, and this one as well. We need a good run out of here. Yes. Oh yes, save 1.5 seconds. Right, this corner we need to nail. That's the one we've gone wide twice. We knowed at that time. The gap has widened even more. Let's see what it is at the next split. It is over 2 seconds now. So we've pretty much got this one wrapped up. Okay. Out of this one, then we start going up the hill. See if he closes in at all in the last part of this lap. Next split coming up now. No, it's extended, so it's almost 2.5 seconds. It's a pretty shocking corner, that one. Final corner. Okay, good run out of here. And that's another race done on these Superleggeras. We crash across the line. Job well done. That one went a lot better after we got to grips with it. We beat the Panigale S. Right, next race. Imola. Let's see how this one goes. Proper short circuit. I know this one a lot better than the last two we've done. So let's go do this. See how we do on the Superleggera against the Panigale S's. Through into the lead already. Let's check out. Oh no, he's right behind us. But we've still got it nailed. As we go up the hill. Try not to wheelie. Oh yeah, we're pulling away already. Got this horrible braking zone coming up. Keeping the rear on the ground pretty much. Brake a bit too late into there, your rear comes right up in the air, and of course you can't tip into the corner, so you end up going very, very wide. Up the hill again, got a chicane coming up. Still well in time for that. Again, keeping the front end down, but we have pulled away by quite a margin now. Double left hander, a bit wide into the first part. It's over 2.6 seconds a gap. Now we've got to think about the next chicane for the end. So around here on the brakes now. Oh wait, shit! It's not the chicane circuit. Well, that's embarrassing. We've just completely fucked that up and lost a shitload of time to the AI. Oh dear. I just assumed it was the full GP circuit with the chicane at the end, but it isn't. So at least we know that next time round. We're going to have to start pulling away again. 1.3 seconds. I can't believe I done that. I should have looked at the track layout before I started the race. Never mind. I think it's just because so used to using that last chicane, especially seeing as we just done the league race there this week. I got my braking markers sorted for the last chicane and don't even need it. It's fine. There we go. Almost 2 seconds again. It's the same guy on the Panigale S. She came right. So let's not forget, we don't need to brake for the last chicane. It is not there in this race. We just gotta go straight. Double left hander. That was better through the, well, maybe a little bit too well through that corner, over the curb. Right, no chicane. Let's carry on going, let's not brake. Let's just keep going. Okay, one more lap to go. Let's make it a good one. We're almost revving out. Through the flip-flop. Of course, we're going to win this one. But by how much? 2.7 seconds. Shall we see if we can win it by 4? Can we pull out another 1.3 seconds? Let's see if we can. Let's see what it is at the next split. Surely it's over 3 seconds now. It is 3.5 seconds, so 4 seconds is looking very, very likely. It might even be quicker. Alright. Last couple of corners. It's over 5 seconds! So, it is over 4 seconds, but it's over 5 seconds. Wasn't expecting it to be that big. But there we go! Another win on the Ducati Superleggera 1299. Awesome bike. Enjoying the bike. It's feeling good. It goes like hell. All round, pretty decent bike. So what did we win by overall? 7.1 seconds. Fucking hell. Well, there we go, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to leave this video a like if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel for more content. I shall see you guys in the next video. See you.